Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to my channel, Shared Smiles by DM. Today's topic is, of course, God's love always moving. So I'm going to share with you guys my plans for this week and talk to you a little bit about how the past couple of days has been for me. When I say days, I mean weeks. So first, forgive me for being away for so long. On this recording, I went ahead and put my washi and some of my stickers down before I started doing this planning portion. So this is the portion that I'm going to record and share with you guys. So let's get right into it. Well, these past couple of weeks have been some of the most, I'm not going to say uncomfortable, but kind of shaky. However, they ended well. They ended wonderful for me. It was a mix of emotions these past couple of weeks. So I'll start off with January the 25th. I went to my aunt's 50th wedding anniversary, and oh my gosh, it was such a blessing and a joy to see her and her family honor and bless their 50 years of union. It was so beautiful. And y'all, she wore the dress that my grandmother, her mother, wore on her 50th wedding anniversary. So it was such a beautiful event. I did have a meltdown and a breakdown because I had to leave the event due to not feeling well, and I was kind of torn in my emotions, always being blocked from being around the things and people that I love the most. So such a beautiful event. After my breakdown, my brother, who is also my pastor, and my sister, they came and prayed with me, and that just solidified that whole moment for me to be grateful that I was able to be present in that moment. I'm putting birthday stickers on the 17th and 18th because my god brother and god sister's birthday are on those days, and their younger brother birthday was on the 15th, the week in before. So I thank God for that. Happy birthday, y'all. And here I am at the Memorial Hermann Breast Cancer Center.
Waiting room to do my mammogram, and this is the big old machine that they're going to use to test these breasts. So I have a really bad headache today, and it's more so on my left side than any, so I'm drinking me some a little caffeine to see if it's gonna help with my headache to alleviate it. But for praying blessings and positive reporting after this test and relief for my head. Talk to you guys later.
And great news, glam fam. My test results came back negative for breast cancer. When I got that report, and that was when everything had to shift, and I hadn't even made it to my other doctor's appointments yet. It was just like, don't you went into this thinking you was about to get this horrendous news, and look how God turned all of that around, and the test results came back negative. It was like, snap back done, get it together. You know whose you are, and you know that it's important that what you are declaring and where your faith is has to align up even with your thoughts. And y'all, I will contest that that's a journey within itself. When you are going through, it's somewhat difficult to keep a positive mind and have faith. You may be saying it, but your thoughts are thinking something totally different. And I just had to be reminded, done, get it together. I had grown to a place where my thoughts was aligning with my faith, and in that moment it was like, even though I was declaring the great things to come out, I was anticipating something not so great coming from these physicians. So it gave me, I guess, a boost to approach my other doctor's appointments and going to see my neurologist and PCP. Me going to see my neurologist, she referred me to, I don't know what her field is called, but I'll update you guys as this journey continues to see, to seek this therapist. I'm going to call her a therapist, but she does neurotherapy. And basically the way it was explained to me, she'll do like an EEG of my brain to record my brain waves and then figure out a neurotherapeutic way to alter my brain waves from responding to pain. So I'm interested in how that's gonna go too. And I'm gonna be starting home physical occupational, and I think we're talking about cognitive therapy. I'll keep y'all updated on it, but I'll try to do some recording of my therapy sessions if it could help someone else as they're going through. Then my doctor's appointment with my primary care provider, it was very great and very informative. We basically, you know, discussed what my desires were in regards to further testing for my spine. I've been going back and forth trying to get some testing scheduled, but the testing they want to do is hazardous to me because I'm allergic to media contrast. So they had suggested to do an MRI with contrast, but I'm allergic to the gabalinian. And when I say allergic, y'all, like fatally allergic. It's, I don't want to experience that ever. And so then they also suggested alternative would be a CT scan where they infuse iodine into my spine to get the imaging. But I'm allergic to iodine. So those two are out of the picture, and we'll see where we go from there and what will be the alternative for testing. So keep me lifted. But I'll keep you guys posted as well for that too. So I want to share with you guys, there's a song called Reckless Love that ministered to me so much and basically solidified the confirmation of everything after these past 2-3 weeks. It's been like, you know, no matter what I've gone through, God is showing how much he loves me and how much his love is conquering everything, even my thoughts. And there's lyrics in this song where it says that there's no shadow you won't light up, no mountain you won't climb up coming after me. And it says, oh, how you chase me down. I don't know the exact lyrics. I can't sing the song to y'all now, but the song ministers to me. I'm gonna post the link to the song with the lyrics so that you guys can experience it as well. But it just confirmed everything for me in this month of February. You know, it's the month of love, where love is displayed, you know, by those that are in relationships. They display their love or their love for their children during the month of February. It's like on display extra. And it confirmed for me how, man, done, God loves you. So even in your prayers, for those of you that are going through similar situations like myself, or just life period, even if you're in your prayers, if you're declaring a thing, make sure that your thoughts are lining up with your declarations as well. So I'm hoping that can help someone as it helped me. I had got my little reminder of check that, you know, God loves you, and is nothing that you can do and nothing that you have done that will cause him not to love you anymore. So in just reflecting on these past couple of weeks, I try to write down every day where I find God's love always moving. I do a daily notion of it. And man, these past 3 weeks for it to end the way that it ended, and me, you know, starting off the way that things are starting off. His love has been forever moving for me and around me, surrounding me, and that I'm grateful for. So here we are. Of course, you see me where how I plan. I kind of put my schedule up top, and then I list out or write out or journal out in my day or reflection of my day where or how I saw God's love always moving for me. I use the bottom portion of my planner for that. So that's what we're doing here. And because it's Black History Month, I use the Ava DuVernay, her sticker and her quote. And I think next week I'm going to use that sticker I just showed y'all. So, and this is a vision of my last week. Here's a final shot of this week's plan. And of course, I'll be back to plan and share more story time of my journey with you all. But I do want to ask you guys to do me a favor and comment below on how do you approach the unknown phases of your journey. Share with us. Let's share our smiles of how we can answer this question to be a light to someone else. For me, I'm finding and learning that every day I must find GLAM. You know, y'all, my GLAM fam. And the acronym for GLAM stands for God's Love Always Moving. So I'm growing and learning to find this in every day, and it's helping to keep me balanced and to keep me strong during this journey. I have a little bit of insight to share with you guys. If you don't know GLAM fam, I'm a crafter and I like to plan and journal, as you see. And my latest collection that we released is called the Love Conquers Collection. And if you would like to help us in our movement of sharing smiles, you can shop our collection at www.sharedsmilesbydm.com. And trust me, when you see the final product of the generated smiles that we give with others, it'll bless you as it is blessing me. So make sure you always sharing your smile and always find God's love moving. Until next time.